This video is called Soka Toa. I know that sounds like a lot of mumbo jumbo right now and is fairly meaningless to you, but please bear through this video, write everything down, listen, pay attention, and after this video is done, we'll start doing some practice problems where it really will all start to make sense. So looking here at this screen, you can see some buttons that you may recognize from your calculator. You see something that looks like sin, cos, and tan that you have seen on your calculator. Well, sin is actually pronounced sine, and it is a trig function. Cos is short for cosine, which is another trig function, and tan is short for tangent, which is a third trig function. This is what they are defined as. They are all ratios where the sine is represented in a right triangle as the as I'm sorry, the sine is defined as the opposite over the hypotenuse. So just write that down. We'll practice what that means later, but hopefully you recognize opposite and hypotenuse as being sides of a right triangle. So we will be taking side lengths of a right triangle, and you'll have to pick the opposite side and the hypotenuse side. The cosine function is designed as adjacent over hypotenuse. So again, when you're dealing with cosine, you'll be picking two sides of a right triangle, the adjacent side and the hypotenuse side. And lastly, the tangent, opposite over adjacent. So we have our three trig functions. Sine is opposite over hypotenuse, cosine as adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent as opposite over adjacent. These three things you will have to have memorized, but I'm about to give you a shortcut or a kind of a helpful hint to remember what is what. So like I said, a helpful way to remember this is called Soka Toa. Well, what does that stand for? The soak part says that the sine of some angle, I'll just call it angle A for now, equals the opposite over the hypotenuse. So soak, S-O-H, is sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Where the ka helps you remember the cosine of some angle, I'll call it angle A right now, is the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. Where finally, the tangent of some angle, for now I'll call it A, is opposite over adjacent. So Soka Toa, I actually, instead of writing it like Soka Toa like that, I like writing it like this. Sum, S-O-H, C-A-H, T-O-A. By writing it this way, it helps you remember that you have to make a fraction with the opposites and the hypotenuses, or the adjacent and hypotenuse, or opposite and adjacent. And it helps you remember what goes in the numerator, what goes in the denominator. Really, it's just the order it's written. The first letter tells you sine, cosine, or tangent. The second letter tells you what goes in the numerator, and the third letter tells you what goes in the denominator. Now, some of you might say, that's great, but I can't even remember Soka Toa. So when I was in high school, my teacher taught me a mnemonic to help me remember, and it goes like this. Some old horse caught a horse taking oats away. So you can remember some old horse is your so, sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Caught a horse is the ka, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, and taking oats away represents the toa, T-O-A. Tangent is opposite over adjacent. So like I said earlier, this is something you are going to have memorized. You are going to use it a lot in this chapter when you're dealing with right triangles, so it will help you to make sure you know this. So do you have to have it memorized? Yes, but if you can simply remember the Soka Toa, if you can memorize that, then you should be able to solve any problem you need. So if you're going to have to memorize something, right here is what I highly recommend that you do. It should be written on the top of every homework assignment for this chapter. You should write it on the top of every quiz and every test because it can help you a lot.